modulus 1 a bit thin. Our edge geometry should be around 2 millimeters at this stage. So I'm going to take a bit of metal off so that it doesn't crack in the heat treatment. I don't work with gloves at this stage because I need to feel where I'm applying pressure on the blade to get the right shape. So before it gets too hot, I'll give it a quick dip in water every now and then. So I start with a punch line. That's where the bevel starts and I grind towards the tip. So this is what we are starting to see. I want to get all these forging hammer marks out, but I will leave the forging texture in on the spine and the ricasso area here. I'm just going to get these little bits out near the edge here. Grind what's called a stress riser, and it just gives a crack an excuse to run, so we get rid of any opportunity to catch my look. This feature on a forge blade is unique to a forge knife. It's called the choil, and it's where you start forcing the metal out from the billet to form the cutting edge on the bevel. So I'm just cleaning the tang off a bit to just make sure it also tapers. It's not necessary for that to be 100% clean. It goes into the handle of the knife, and any roughness basically forms a better bond with the epoxy. What happens is we heat it up till it's non-magnetic when it's forced to knot, and that's at the stage where the molecules are vibrating so fast it cannot stick to the magnet, so it becomes non-magnetic. Once it's at critical, it's important to quench it immediately. We're going to be quenching the bottom third of the edge. Overnight, and then we can finish that blade.